Hello students, this is Mrs. Jennifer Cruz from Leelavati Lalji Dayal College of Commerce. And in today's class, students, we are going to study economics, chapter number 10, Foreign Trade of India. So before starting with this interesting chapter, students, let me tell you all that the total weightage of this chapter is 6 marks with option and 4 marks without option. So let's begin with this interesting chapter. So students, let us first understand the meaning of internal trade, okay? So buying and selling of goods and services within the boundaries of a nation are referred to as internal trade, okay? Or it can also be termed as your home trade. For example, if goods produced in Maharashtra are sold in states like West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh or Tamil Nadu, it can be termed as your internal trade. So trade which is happening in our own home country is termed as internal trade. Then let's now understand foreign trade. Okay, so foreign trade is trade between the different countries of the world. Okay, it is also termed as international trade or external trade. Okay, so according to Wasserman and Hultman, international trade consists of transactions between residents of different countries. Okay, now there are three types of foreign trade, students: import, export and anthropoid. Import means to buy goods from one country, export means to sell the goods to some other country, and anthropoid is a combination of your import and export. You buy from one country and then sell it to another country. Now, the first very important answer of this chapter is role of foreign trade. Okay, so first point, foreign trade is useful to earn foreign exchange for the country. Okay, so you're in foreign trade will help you to earn foreign exchange through import and export activities. Second, encourages investment. So you're in foreign trade encourages investment for the producers to reach beyond the domestic market. Next one is division of labor and specialization. Okay, it leads to optimum utilization of resources. Okay, and whatever is available into the worldwide, that can be used, okay, in a very proper manner. Next one is optimum allocation and utilization of resources. So due to specialization, okay, the rational allocation of resources at the international level can be possible. Next one is stability in price level. Okay, so foreign trade, students, it helps to maintain a stability of demand and supply to maintain the price level of the commodity. Next one, availability of multiple choices. So foreign trade, okay, it leaves the customer with multiple choices to purchase, okay, as per his standard of living, and also it helps to improve the standard of living. Next one is it brings reputation and helps to earn goodwill. Okay, so foreign trade, it brings goodwill, it brings reputation for the country in the global market. Okay, so with this we've completed the first important answer of this chapter, that is role of foreign trade. So let's have a quick recap on the points. First, to earn foreign exchange. Second, encourages investment. Third, division of labor and specialization. Fourth, optimum allocation and utilization of resources. Fifth, stability in the price level. Sixth, availability of multiple choices. And the last one is it's bring reputation and helps to earn goodwill. Now, your own students, if you can see the composition, okay, and the direction of foreign trade, okay. So your first one is it is helping in increasing the share of the national income. It increases, okay, the volume and it adds value to trade. Okay, so there is, because of foreign trade, there is change in the consumption of export, change in the consumption of imports as well. There is oceanic trade that is happening and is development of new ports also coming in because of the direction of India's foreign trade is improving. Next one, students, is the recent trend in export. Okay, so here in this answer, students, here you have to remember certain numbers, okay, figures, like what is the increase in this year at so much, next product as if your it became this much, okay? So first one, the recent trend in export for engineering goods, okay? So in 2010 and 11 to 2014 and 15, it has grown from $16 billion to $24.8 billion, okay? So from 16, it has become $24.8 billion. Then you have petroleum products. So there has been a steady growth, okay, from 4.3 to 20.1% in the year 2014 and 15. Next one is chemical and chemical products. So the share of this product in the export market is 10.4% in 2014 and 15. Then you have gems and jewelries. It has, you know, raised 13.3%. Till 2014 and 15. Then you have textiles and ready-made garments. So here in students, the total share in the exports in the year 2014 and 15 was 11.3% of the Indian export, okay? So if you've seen all these five types of goods, you just have to remember the trend in the export, how it has increased over a period of years. Next one, student speaks about the trend in imports. So petroleum, students, today, currently, it is 31% of the total imports. Then gold, okay, it has declined to $27.5 billion in 2013 and 14. Then you have fertilizers, it has again declined to 1.3% in 2016 and 17. And the last one is iron and steel. You again have a decline out here to 20% in the year 16 and 17, okay? So with this, students, now let's come to the next topic, that is balance of trade, okay? What do we understand by balance of trade? So balance of trade, students, is the difference between the value of a country's export and import for a given period of time, okay? So balance of trade is also referred as the international trade balance, okay? So according to Samuelson, if the export value is greater than the import value, it is called as the trade surplus, and if import value is greater than the export value, then it is called as trade deficit, okay? So what is balance of trade in simple words, students? The difference between the country's export and the country's import, okay? So with this, students, we've completed the chapter foreign trade. Thank you.